the 5 biggest editing mistakes to avoid when creating YouTube videos with Adobe Premiere Pro. Hello, my name is Kelly Wakasa. I'm a YouTuber here in NYC and I have 1.6 million lovely subscribers. I've been making videos for over a decade and today I'm gonna put you on to 5 tips that I wish I knew when I first started. So let's get into that. Number 1, audio pops. To all my beginners out there, let's level up your audio. There's this thing called an audio pop when in between 2 clips, it makes this sound. Basically, it happens when you don't transition the audio properly. So what you can do down here in the timeline, to easily transition the audio using either the right click to apply the default audio transition, or you can use your mouse to smoothly transition the audio. There's also these new fade audio transitions where you can literally click these boxes and make your audio fade or just transition more smoothly. So now our audio sounds more like this.
Being out of high school and I went to school.
And less like this.
Being out of high school and I went to school.
Number 2. Bad music. Now imagine you're watching a video and the music is straight up awful.
That song sucks.
You'd probably end up like me in the clip prior. There is an art to matching the music to the vibe of the video. Now take this montage of me and my girlfriend. Listen to this first song.
That montage sucked.
Even if this was your favorite song, you shouldn't use it. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't match the vibe. But now if you use a song like this, oh my gosh, feels like I'm in the moment. Feels like I'm falling in love and I'm not even, well, I'm in that clip. But you know what I'm saying? Like you're not in that clip. I'm gonna show you another example. So here is a good montage. Here is a bad montage. And let me put you on a little secret. It's because of the music. You make good choices with the music, it changes the whole video. Trust me. Number 3, spamming transitions. Now, it's cool to use a transition every once in a while, but if you're constantly using the same transition, it's actually not cool anymore. It's actually just kind of annoying and hard to digest as a viewer. So instead, just use a simple jump cut. You can do this by clicking C and then click, or Command K, or hitting Q for left and W for right, or setting up your own shortcut in the keyboard shortcuts. And that's how you can get a simple transition that's gonna be very digestible. Number 4. Cutting without purpose. I'm all for well-paced videos, but that doesn't mean cutting everything out. One of the most important tools we have as editors is the cut. See? Still not cut. Kinda raw, kinda boring. It needs this. Boom! There it was. A cut. Made it a little bit faster there. But I will say if a video is just cut extremely fast for no reason, it's pointless. Whether it's on short or long form video, it's brain rot. So how do you cut with purpose? Well, obviously this will evolve as you become a better editor, but quickly I'll give you a few examples. When it's a funny moment, I like to cut the background music and keep the clip raw.
Are you gonna propose to me?
Is our honeymoon gonna be like this, bro?
Bro, way more lit. This is whack.
Bro, what are we talking about?
When it's a long monologue and I'm just explaining something to a viewer that's just normal, I like to cut right before I talk and right after I talk.
Oh, it says that I'm overweight? Come on now, I'm not overweight. That's crazy. This is where I draw the line. It says here that my body age is 29. I'm 24, that's disrespectful. Body type, slightly fat. Dude, come on, I'm getting roasted.
When it's emotional, I cut more slowly and allow more breathing room.
Oh my gosh, Hunter! I gotta check it off?
Finish it off! Finish
oh my gosh, job, finish!
And when it's exciting, I like to make quick cuts. Number 5, not using B-roll. What is B-roll? B-roll are clips most of the time without talking or shots that you don't use as the main shot. It basically acts as a visual aid to what you were saying. Here's an example of why you should use B-roll. Let me tell you a quick story about this ice hotel. I went to Sweden with my girlfriend. I went to this ice hotel. It was freezing cold, but we got to see the northern lights and it was awesome. Oh, you were just looking at my face the whole time. Let me tell it again, but we're using B-roll. I went to Sweden with my girlfriend and we traveled to the middle of nowhere to this ice hotel where it was freezing inside, but everything was made out of ice and it was spectacular. And we even saw the northern lights. that was a lot better because you got a visual representation and it made the video 10 times better and it matched exactly what you were saying. Guys, it's not rocket science. It's B-roll. So those were my five biggest editing mistakes to avoid. Also, just wanted to say that everybody starts somewhere, so hopefully you took something away from today's video. So good luck with your editing, and of course, keep learning with Adobe Premiere Pro.